आज हम देखने वाले हैं आवर फर्स्ट चैप्टर इन F1। हमारा फर्स्ट चैप्टर का नाम है द बिजनेस ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। ओके, सो इन दिस चैप्टर वी आर गोइंग टू टॉक अबाउट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन होता क्या है, कितने टाइप्स ऑफ ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस आर देयर, वो टाइप्स में भी डिफरेंसेस क्या है एक टाइप से दूसरे टाइप से, व्हाट आर द कमर्शियल सेक्टर्स दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस कैन ऑपरेट इनटू। सो ऑल दीज टॉपिक्स वी आर गोइंग टू सी इन योर चैप्टर नंबर 1। तो शुरू करते हैं, लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट इज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन फर्स्ट। ओके, तो बेसिकली फॉर एग्जाम्पल अगर मैं अकेली एक बिजनेस रन कर रही हूँ, सो द काइंड ऑफ प्रॉफिट दैट आई वुड बी गेटिंग इज वेरी लेस कंपेयर टू अगर मैं दो तीन लोगों को एम्प्लॉय करूंगी, हम सब साथ में मिलके इफ यू रन माई बिजनेस, वो जो प्रॉफिट मिलेगा वो कई गुना ज्यादा होता है, राइट? सो इफ एनी पर्सन इज डूइंग समथिंग इंडिविजुअली, द काइंड ऑफ एनर्जी, द काइंड ऑफ एफिशिएंसी, द काइंड ऑफ स्पेशलाइजेशन दैट यू आर गोइंग टू गेट फ्रॉम दैट इज गोइंग टू बी लेस कंपेयर्ड टू इफ इट इज डन एज अ ग्रुप। ओके, तो लेट्स जस्ट पुट दिस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ अ डेफिनेशन विच इज कॉल्ड एज एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। ओके, तो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन में क्या होता है, इट इज अ सोशल अरेंजमेंट। सोशल अरेंजमेंट मीन्स नॉट जस्ट वन पर्सन वर्किंग, बट one person is going to take the help of two people or three people, so it is going to be group of people who are going to work. Okay, next important thing is jab lot of people are working together, sabka goals alag alag nahi hona chahiye, all of them should be working for one particular goal. Okay, so which is called as collective goal. Okay, also suppose I just told you, if I am the only person who is doing my business, I should only handle my purchases, I should only handle my sales, I should only handle my customers, I should only handle my delivery, ki sari cheeze sirf mujhe dekhna padega, and I won't be able to specialize in any one of them. But if I hire a lot of people, so if I have an employee, and if I'm making him specialist in sales, and if I'm hiring one more employee, and if I'm making him specialist in marketing, so the specialization that my organization is going to get, because of which my profits are also going to increase. So yahan pe specialization is also one thing that I can take advantage of. So if lot of people are working together, the kind of environment that you are into is also called as an organization. Okay, so now one more point we have to note over here is yahan pe jo kaam hota hai wo control tarike mein hota hai, sabka rules, sabka roles, sabko kisko communicate karna hai, kya performance is expected from them, everything is already pre decided. To ek organization mein coordination hona chahiye, ek organization mein controlled performance hona chahiye. If everybody is doing the same thing, duplication ho jata hai, right? So there should be a controlled performance. So that is what is about organization. If I can take some examples about organizations, I can take examples of police stations, hospitals, schools, Reliance. So all these are some of the examples of organizations. Okay, so before we move ahead, let's understand about what is the definition that we just studied. So organization means something where everybody is working for a collective goal. Okay, and yahan pe it's a social arrangement, because lot of people coming together, so it's just a social arrangement. And as I told you, there is going to be a controlled performance. Okay, so that is about your organization. So moving ahead, why they are formed. Why are they formed? I just explained you. They are formed because we will share skills with each other. We can share knowledge with each other. So if I'm only person who is doing business, sirf mera knowledge applicable hoga. But if I'm having 2-3 people who are also helping me in conducting my business, sabka knowledge mere business ko run karne mein help ho jata hai. Okay? And the next one is specialization. So each of us can specialize into our particular area. And the next one is pool resources. So if I'm the only person, if I want capital, if I want any resource, मुझे अकेले में अरेंज करने में दिक्कत आएगी. बट इफ आई टेक हेल्प ऑफ फ्यू पीपल, इट इज वेरी इजी फॉर मी टू पूल रिसोर्सेज आल्सो, एंड इन अ वे इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प माय प्रॉफिट्स, और इफ इट इज अ नॉन प्रॉफिट आल्सो, इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प टू अचीव माय ऑब्जेक्टिव. सो दिस इज आल्सो वन ऑफ द रीजंस हम ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस फॉर्म करने के लिए. ओके, सो इफ लॉट ऑफ पीपल आर वर्किंग टूगेदर, वी कैन अचीव अ बेनिफिट कॉल्ड सिनर्जी. सिनर्जी मतलब सबसे सब सबको मिलाने के बाद जो एनर्जी यू गेट, इट इज गोइंग टू बी कहीं गुना ज्यादा कंपेयर टू द एनर्जी दैट यू वुड गेट एज अ सिंगल पर्सन. ओके, बीट एफिशिएंसी, बीइंग द काइंड ऑफ टाइम दैट यू आर गोइंग टू टेक टू फिनिश एनी टास्क, दैट इज गोइंग टू बी कंप्लीटली डिफरेंट इफ इट इज गोइंग टू बी ग्रुप ऑफ पीपल. सो दैट इज अबाउट व्हाई ऑर्गेनाइजेशंस आर फॉर्म्ड. ओके, सो लेट्स मूव ऑन टू next category. We are going to talk about different types of business organization and their main characteristics. Okay, so basically, if I have to say, organizations can be divided. First category, main baat karungi commercial organizations. Okay, so what are commercial organizations? So commercial organizations, wo organizations hote hai jinka main purpose hota hai profit. Okay. So any organization which is working for the motive of profit is called as a commercial organization. So for example, if you can take, you can take example of supermarkets, okay, you can take example of Tata, you can take example of Birlas. So all these are commercial organizations. So ye commercial organizations mein, as I told you, profit is their motive. Okay, so moving ahead, commercial organizations mean we will see a lot of different types in commercial organizations. So the first type we are going to talk about is sole traders. Okay, sole trader is nothing but there is a person who is the owner of the business and a lot of people are going to work under him. Okay, so he is the head and he is going to manage the other people. And other people are going to help him achieve his goal. So they are called as sole traders. In our country, we can see examples of lot of kirana stores. Okay, usually they are headed by one person and lot of employees work under him. So moving ahead, we will be talking about partnerships. Okay, so partnerships means one or two people are going to be the heads and inke niche they will have employees who will be working under them. Okay, so we have lot of CA firms in our country as partnerships. Everybody will be working for the collective goals of the partners. So in dono sole traders and partnerships mein what is the thing is, अगर आपके बिजनेस में इफ इट इज इनकरिंग एनी लॉसेस, द लॉसेस विल बी बेयर्ड बाय द ओनर्स. ओके, इनका जो लॉसेस होता है, इनका जो लायबिलिटी होता है, उनका लायबिलिटी है अनलिमिटेड लायबिलिटी, मतलब अगर बिजनेस में कुछ लॉसेस है तो आपके पर्सनल एसेट्स भी यू कैन सेल. आई मीन द लीगल स्टेटस सेज दैट इवन योर पर्सनल एसेट्स आर लायबल इन केस योर बिजनेस इज गेटिंग एनी लॉसेस. ओके, बट यू वोंट हैव दिस केस व्हेन आई एम टॉकिंग अबाउट कॉर्पोरेशंस और कंपनीज. वहां पे लायबिलिटी लिमिटेड होता है, देयर वी कैन नॉट कम एंड टेक योर पर्सनल एसेट्स. ओके, सो दैट इज अबाउट सोल ट्रेडर्स एंड पार्टनरशिप्स. So moving on, as I have already told you a brief introduction, we are going to talk about limited liability companies. Okay, so limited liability, liability means aapka obligation kitna ho sakta hai. Agar loss, if the business is going to loss, aap loss kitna bear kar sakte ho? How much is given to you? What is your share in the losses? That is about limited. तो आपका जो लायबिलिटी होता है वो लिमिटेड होता है, आपके पर्सनल एसेट्स के पीछे नहीं आएंगे इफ इट इज अ लिमिटेड लायबिलिटी कंपनी. ओके, सो इन लिमिटेड लायबिलिटी कंपनीज आल्सो वी हैव टू टाइप्स, वन इज प्राइवेट एंड द अदर वन इज पब्लिक. ओके, तो पब्लिक कंपनी, सपोज पब्लिक कंपनी का नाम है एक्स, तो एक्स के बाद दे हैव टू राइट पीएलसी इफ इट इज अ पब्लिक कंपनी. If it is a private company, X ke baad, they will have to write limited. Okay? So, what happens in a public company and what happens in a private company? To private company mein jo owners hote hai, it is, there is a limitation to it. Only limited number of people can become the owners in a private company. But agar aapka ek public company hai, to jo owners ho sakte hai, wo bahut sare log ho sakte hai. Okay? And in a private company, suppose I have become a shareholder in a private company. So the owners in the companies are called as shareholders. So agar main private company mein shareholder if I have become. So in that case, if I want to sell off my share, then there are some restrictions. Main easily kisi aur ko apna share sell nahi kar sakti hun. And easily anybody cannot buy shares in a private company. Okay, but whereas, agar if it is a public company, if I am a shareholder in a public company, I can easily sell my shares to anybody. There are no restrictions. Okay, so this is also one of the difference. Private company people cannot ask for funds from public, but whereas public company can source its funds from public also. So that is about a public company. So usually whatever companies are listed on the stock exchanges, all of them are public companies, because in a stock exchange, anybody can buy shares. Okay. So if you see Reliance, if you see Tata, if you see TCS, if you see ITC, all these are public companies in India. Okay. So private companies are something, companies where there are restrictions to the transferability of shares and who cannot offer their shares to public as general. So that is about your limited liability companies. So when we are talking about different types of business organizations, jisme se humne what are commercial organizations, that is what we just saw. So commercial organization ka opposite hai non-for-profit organizations. Okay. So what are non-for-profit organization? As the name says, non-for-profit means they're not running their organization for profit. Their objective is different. So there are a lot of categories in non-for-profit organizations also. Unka basic hai, social welfare is their basic motive. So schools, you can see government schools, you can see government hospitals, you can see blood banks. All these are some organizations jinka objective alag alag hai. Suppose if it is a school, school's objective is to promote education. Suppose if it is a hospital, they are doing work related to health. So sabka non-for-profit organizations, maybe objectives will be different, but everybody is working not for profit, but to do some welfare to the society. So that is about your non-for-profit organizations. So moving on, this is one type in which you can divide the organizations. So moving on to the second type of classification that you can do is about public sector and private sector. And then you have NGOs. Okay, so now let's talk about these three things. Public sector means जहाँ पे government is involved, it is called as public sector. And जहाँ पे government is not involved, it is called as private sector. Okay, so if I'm talking about private companies and public companies, they can be into public sector or private sector based on government's involvement. Okay, so in public sector, I can take examples of ONGC, BHEL. So all these are into public sector, or I can take an example of railways. So they are into public sector. When I'm moving on to private sector, obviously it is owned by private people and government ka isme zyada involvement nahi hota hai. So like we have our Reliance, ITC, all these are private sector organizations. Moving on to non-governmental organizations, yes, again, their objective is not profit. Okay, these are some organizations apart from government which are working for the welfare of the society. So we can see a lot of blood banks, lot of clubs, lot of swimming pools as NGOs over here. Okay, so this is about your second type of classification. So moving on to the third type, you can also find a type called cooperatives. Okay, this is very interesting. So in our India, the best example that I can give you is about Amul. Okay, so Amul's full form is Anand Milk Union Limited. This was started in Anand. Anand is a village in Gujarat. So वहाँ पे बहुत सारे ये जो milk producers है, milk producers means small people who extract the milk and they are actually called as farmers. तो ये छोटे छोटे लोग मिलके they have formed a cooperative society which is called as Amul. Okay, so you can see Amul's presence is everywhere. We also have the butter or milk of Amul very often, right? So it is started by small farmers in Gujarat, but now you can see the name of it spread everywhere. Okay, agar ek single farmer hota, so I am sure he wouldn't have achieved so much as what Amul has achieved as a cooperative society. So yahan pe kya hota hai, some small producers, they come together, they can form a cooperative society, and jo bhi profit ye society ko milta hai, it directly goes to the farmers. And yahan pe jo voting process hota hai, one member will get one vote. Okay, but whereas in companies that you see, wahan pe aapke paas जितने शेयर है आपको उतना परसेंटेज ऑफ वोट्स मिलते हैं, बट इन कोऑपरेटिव सोसाइटी इट इज अबाउट वन मेंबर वन वोट. सो मोस्टली 75% ऑफ द प्रॉफिट्स गोज टू द फार्मर्स डायरेक्टली, गोज टू द मेंबर्स डायरेक्टली. ओके, सो रादर देन गोइंग इनटू एनीबॉडी एल्सस हैंड्स. सो दैट इज अबाउट योर कोऑपरेटिव्स. वन मोर एग्जांपल इफ आई कैन गिव यू अबाउट कोऑपरेटिव्स इज इफको. ओके, सो इफको इज Indian Farmers Fertilizer Cooperative. If you can see, there is a metro station of IFFCO Chowk also in Gurgaon. So this is also one of the cooperatives in India. And these Amul and IFFCO are, they come in the top 300 cooperatives in the world. So you can see how well they are running their organizations. So that is about different types of organizations. So moving on, let's see some of the differences. How business organizations differ. Okay. So basically, we have just seen they can differ as per ownership. Okay, so in sole traders, you can see that there is one owner. In partnership, there are two or more owners. In a private company, it is again a closely held company. Kam owners hai compared to public companies, but yes, there can be many number of owners in a private company, but in a public company, the ownership can be unlimited. So in this way, the organizations can also differ based on ownership. Moving on to objectives. Objectives we have just seen. Kuch organizations profit oriented hai, some organizations are non for profit, and in profit or non for profit also sabka alag alag objectives ho sakte hai based on what kind of job they are into. Okay, and then moving on to the third category, that is activities. Okay, the kind of activities that each organization does. So if it is a manufacturing organization, they will have to perform different kinds of activities, means acts like purchasing, processing, selling. So these are some activities. If it is a service sector, if it is an organization in a service sector, unka jo activities hai, wo alag hote hai. So again, activities means the kinds of acts that organizations do. This way also we can differentiate between organizations. And moving on to the next one, that is sources of funding. Yeah, sources of funding means from where is the organization getting money from? I mean, first to start an organization, you need money, right? So where am I getting my money from to start or to run my business? So that is about run my organization. That is about sources of funding. So as I told you, in sole trader partnerships and private limited, the sources of funding is closely held. But whereas in a public limited company, what happens is the funding can be from anybody in the public. So that is my sources of funding. Okay. And next, moving on to size. Of course, organizations can be as small as Kirana stores, and they can be as large as big supermarket chains. So there can be small organizations and there can be big organizations. And then moving on to liability. We have just seen liability. So liability means aapka limited liability hota hai in your private companies and public companies, and aapka unlimited liability hota hai in sole traders and partnerships. So in a company, suppose I have purchased one share. Okay, and the face value of share is say $10. Okay, so company, suppose if I'm losing anything in the company, the maximum that I'll be losing is only $10. Isse zyada they cannot take or they cannot claim from my personal funds. Okay, but whereas in partnerships and sole traders, aisa nahi hai, aapka personal assets bhi liable hai. So that is about liability. So in this way, the organizations can differ from each other. So moving on to the last topic in this chapter, we are going to see about industrial and commercial sectors in which business organization operate. Okay, so there are a lot of sectors and commercial sectors that we are talking about in which a business organization can operate. So basically aap bahut kuch examples le sakte hain. Let's start from the scratch. Pehle hamara hua karta tha agricultural country, right? So in agricultural country, you know what happens. We are into farming. We produce, we produce crops, and the crops are processed, and the final rice or wheat is made, and that is called as agricultural sector. So organizations can be established in agricultural sector also. And then we have some sectors which is about mining. So in mining, what happens is we extract mines from the underground and we process these minerals. So all these organizations which are into mining industry can also be one of those organizations in this particular sector. So moving on, we also have some organizations in finance sector, like you can take banks, you can take Muthoot Finance, all these are into finance sector, that where they lend money to others. Okay, so next we have retailers. So what do these retailers do? they buy goods from the wholesaler and they sell it to the customers. So some organizations can be into retail sector also, like your supermarket chains. Then moving on to the service sector. So right now, whatever is the benefit that you're taking from my organization, this organization is into service sector. So you can take service sector examples as transportation, internet connection, Hotstar, all these are into service sector. Then, because in service sector, the goods that we are talking about are intangible in nature. So ye intangibility kya hota hai? Intangibility is something that you can feel. आप उसको टच नहीं कर सकते हो, आप उसको फिजिकल अपीयरेंस में नहीं देख सकते हो, बट आप उसको जरूर महसूस कर सकते हो. दैट इज अबाउट सर्विस सेक्टर. सो एंड द लास्ट वन इज ऑफ कोर्स ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. तो ट्रांसपोर्टेशन एक सर्विस भी है. सो दिस कैन ऑल्सो कम इन टू द कैटेगरी ऑफ सर्विस, बट अदरवाइज ऑल्सो इफ यू टेक, एक ट्रांसपोर्टेशन भी सेक्टर हो सकता है. एंड यस, of course these sectors are unlimited, bahut sare, you can still keep adding to this list. It just doesn't end over here. So that is about your organization. So we have finished all the basic points that we have to do in this chapter 1. So yes, before I leave, let me tell you a simple example that aapka ye jo cricket team hai ya football team hai, it's also an organization, because lot of people are going to come together, they are going to play the game, and un sabka ek hi motive hota hai to win the game, right? And each one of them in the team is specialized in their particular area, okay? So when all of them come together, they play, and of course they play with some controls, they have some rules and regulations that they have to follow, right? To unka control performance bhi hota hai. So a football team or a cricket team can also be called as an organization, and yes, they all get the synergy benefit. So I hope you had understood chapter number 1. So we'll be meeting further when we start with chapter number 2. Thank you.